Fame is but a fruit tree, so very unsound. It can never flourish till its stalk is in the ground.
Well, good afternoon, everyone. I am in Tamworth in Arden, Tamworth by Arden. And I'm here to see the grave of Nick Drake. It won't be a long video. I'm on my way down to Wales. This is somewhere I want to come for like 10, 15 years. I thought today would be a good day as I'm on my way down to Wales. So Nick Drake was born here, he grew up here, and he died here. And he is buried in this cemetery. Let me just turn you around. I think he's buried just up here on the left. I'm not, if you're watching this, you've not clicked on to see a random video that I do. You've clicked on it because you're into Nick Drake. So, you know who he is. But I'll go through some background information. So Nick Drake was actually born in Burma, but he moved to Tamworth in Arden with his family when he was just 4 years old. It's a beautiful little village in Warwickshire. He was a really talented kid, talented at education and talented at sports. And he's an incredibly talented musician, and he could play lots of different things. He's an enigma in music and in history. There's no video footage of him playing. I think he only ever did one interview in his life. And he is an enigma, and he wasn't known. He died in obscurity and penniless, as if you know Nick Drake, that's kind of almost his thing, is how well known he was for the talents that he had. He is buried just up here where the guy is. So that guy's painting the grave next to it, so I don't want to disturb him too much. I'll talk to you away from the grave. I kind of prefer to do that anyway. I feel a bit weird talking about the people at the grave in a way. So Nick Drake, look, just quickly some background information. He lived here and he was awarded a scholarship to a college in Cambridge, and before he went there, he went to the south of France to, it's said to have been the freest he felt in his life, and he would play his guitar. There's a story that he met Mick Jones and Keith Richards, but I don't really know much about that. I don't think anybody does. But he moved to Cambridge in the late 60s. I think he was there for 2 years. And he released his first album, Five Leaves Left, in 1969. It is a beautiful album. And Five Leaves Left is apparently when you have like a pack of papers in smoking, it would be a little caption that would come up on his cigarettes. Five Leaves Left. It's also 5 years before he died, which is eerie. The problem with Nick Drake is he was like criminally shy, and performing live, he didn't enjoy it. And the brief reports you can see about him playing live is he would stare at his feet. He he never engaged with any of the audience. And the most, probably the most unique thing about Nick Drake is his finger-picking style and his tunings. So I got into Nick Drake when I was learning guitar, and I can't even remember, I don't play much guitar anymore. I can't remember how it was, but I think it's songs like Northern Sky and Time of No Reply. So guitar is E-A-D-G-B-E. So it's my memory banks for that one. And so yeah, Time of No Reply and Northern Sky, amongst many others, have B-E-B-E-B-E. So like when he was playing live, why he didn't have like a roadie or spare guitars that were tuned up to songs, he would have to retune his guitar between songs, and it took so long, and the audience didn't gravitate towards him, and he didn't gravitate towards the audience, and yeah, and he hated it, so he just stopped playing live. And one of my many disasters, it's now, kids are leaving school now, so I don't want to film my kids, but you know, I don't like to film in a lot of situations. So his first album came out to mixed reviews, unfortunately, which over time, like Nick Drake, by all accounts, you just couldn't like get to grasp with why was he failing? Which is a horrible thing to think of. I'm suddenly in a grip. Then he would release Brighter Lighter about 2 years later, and the year after that, Pink Moon. And they all, none of them sold. I think none of them sold more than 5,000 copies in his lifetime. And the reviews were always very mixed. And he couldn't like deal with this. He couldn't deal with how unsuccessful he was. You listen to Nick Drake's music and you're like, wow, this is incredible. And that's what he thought. And it just never sold. It just didn't make it, as they say. And if you listen to those three albums and beautiful body of work, and his reward was he moved back here to Tamworth and Arden to move back into his parents' house. I went to his parents' house where he died, just been there, so I'll put that on now. So yeah, he moved back here and he was left feeling like he was a failure, and that he let his family down, his parents, and he just retreated into himself, became more and more depressed, and was on three lots of medication for his moods. And November of 1974, he was found dead in the home that I think I've shown you. I'll probably put it back up. And nobody knows if it was suicide or accidental. There was no note. But his friend said he just became so recluse at the end, he just wouldn't leave the house. He was just in a bad way, and ended up culminating in his death. But Nick Drake became pretty big, but he never got a chance to see it. And that, let me turn you around, the church is very. And yeah, so by the 80s, I mean, his last album, Pink Moon, there were some quite favourable reviews. There's one in Rolling Stones from America, which is positive. And I think sometimes the people, when we think about Nick Drake, they think he died, he became successful. He didn't. He wasn't that big. He died in 74. He wasn't that big for the rest of the 70s. But the 80s, like Kate Bush, Paul Weller, R.E.M., The Cure, all cited Nick Drake as influences to them. And he was getting more and more articles published about him. And he was getting bigger and bigger. Compilation albums would get released. And then in 1999, I think it was Volkswagen, used Pink Moon on an advert, and he became even more popular because of that.
I saw it written and I saw it say,
and you're watching this and I'm here, and he reached many people, and his songs are incredibly beautiful, and he left behind a beautiful body of work which has meant so much to so many people. But it's a sad tale of his life, and depression, and how hard we all are on ourselves. I'm sure nobody thought he was a failure that loved him. And people that love you don't think you're a failure if you're thinking that. If we're breathing, you're making somebody happy. He's buried with his mum and his dad. His mum and his dad stay living in the area. And I don't know, I'm sure they reaped the benefit of some of his riches. Let me just show you around Tamworth as I say goodbye. Church. This is his little area. School kids have just finished, so I won't show too much. Please like and subscribe. I'm going to Wales, so another trip. I never seem to do videos in Lincoln anymore. But I am sort of always in Lincoln. I've just seem to fixed it in a trip and I got on another trip. If I can find, there's something to do with the bell and Nick Drake, something to do with his grave, his funeral. And if I find the information for that, I'll put it on. Pretty quick video, but I hope you enjoyed the brief trip to Nick Drake's grave, and like and subscribe for more adventures and videos and graves on this trip.